Good. So first, we have the thermoreceptors, yes? So, in order to feel what is hot and what is cold, we have two separate receptors. First receptor is... So, one more time, we have a separate receptors for cold and for heat. Yes, this is really important. Also, we generally tend to have more of the receptors for cold than for heat. This is also useful information because, for example, when we are in some pain, yes? We tend to bring to the painful place something cold. It is helpful on couple mechanisms, but one of the mechanisms is that when we activate the receptors, some other touch receptors, thermoreceptors, generally some other receptors in the skin, then other than the nociceptors, so the receptors for the pain, the information from those receptors would partially block the pathways of the receptors. Yes? So the information, as you will tell me more in the next question, from the receptors needs to reach the brain. Yes, we have some transduction of the signal through the nerves. And those pathways, you can imagine, that are limited in size. Yes, so when one information tries to get through, it can block some other information. So when we get something cold or hot, or warm at least, it can reduce the pain. However, you have more of the cold receptors in the skin, so cold is more effective in reducing pain than warm. Simply like that. There are some other reasons for it, but this is one of them. Okay, apart from it, about the receptors, this is also important that they are relative, yes? So they are mainly showing the relative temperature. So how the temperature is changing, not only, of course, but also, yes, if you are very cold and we get into the even mediocre temperature, it would feel far warmer than if we would get from some hot place into the same temperature. Yes. Okay, what are the nociceptors? We already started to talk about this. So nociceptors are those pain receptors, yes? Generally, nociceptors are extremely simple structures. They are just three nerve endings. We also tend to have two types of the nociceptors, and more precisely, two types of the passageways for those nociceptors. The fast one and the slow one. So generally, if you, for example, kicked your finger, yes, so you kicked something hard. And it aches. Generally, there is this first very sharp pain, acute pain, that will invoke immediate reaction. Yes? So you would get back your leg, rub your leg, things like that. And after it, there will be a duller, a bit less, of course, less intensive, but far longer lasting pain. Yes? So we have this fast pain just after the stimuli, and this slow, long-lasting pain far after the stimuli that is connected with the reactions to the damage in the tissues. Okay, and proprioceptors. What are the proprioceptors, and what is the proprioception? Generally, the proprioception is that we know what is happening with our body parts. So when we close our eyes, we are able to touch our nose, for example. So how it is achieved? It is achieved through the receptors in our muscles and tendons. So when we change the position of our limbs, yes, we can feel in each joint, let's make it bigger, yes, this is elbow, let's say, that here something is changed, yes. For example, we activated biceps. and the receptors in the biceps will get activated during this action. Receptors in the tendons and around the joint will get activated that something is happening and in which direction we are moving our elbow. Yes. The same would happen in the other muscle that is stretched from in the triceps. And the same schematic is true for all of the receptors, for all of the joints, yes, for all of the muscles. So thanks to this, our brain is able to count everything that is happening and combine this information to tell us where are our body parts. Yes. So this is a general idea. Thank you.